Question: which brand equipment is the most effective at producing grade D breathing air for your job site respirators? The answer will most likely surprise you. Coming up next. Welcome to this week's Primed Insight. My name is Steven. I'm a marketing manager here at BlastOne. Today we're going to clear up a few misconceptions about grade D breathing air. Now, if you're unfamiliar with this term, grade D is a standard of compressed breathing air that ensures the health and safety of blasters and painters relying on job site respirators. It's called grade D in the United States, but is essentially the same exposure standards as the Australian New Zealand standards 1715. For simplicity's sake, I'll be calling it grade D for the remainder of this video, but know the information also applies to Australia and New Zealand. So here are the composition standards for grade D alongside the 1715 standard. Now, each of these components must be met for the compressed air to be deemed grade D, suitable for worker safety. Which leads me back to my original question. What equipment should you buy to ensure you're producing grade D breathing air for your job site respirators? Well, that's actually a trick question because there is no equipment that produces grade D breathing air. Scrubbers, monitors, filters, none of these produce grade D air, the operative word being produce. Furthermore, none of these products can even certify the air going through them is grade D air. Confused? Well, allow me to explain. The air being fed to the respirator generally comes from one of two sources, either a mechanical air compressor or a low-pressure ambient pump, aka free air. Regardless of how it's furnished, that supply air is either grade D or not. And in the case of free air, just because it's coming from an outdoor environment doesn't guarantee it is grade D quality. The principle here is you basically get what you start with. Whatever is drawn into the system, for the most part, gets delivered to the respirator. But what about scrubbers? They eliminate carbon monoxide and hydrocarbons. Yes, that is true, but they still cannot produce nor ensure the resulting product is grade D breathing air. The same is true for filters and monitors. Unfortunately, there currently is no industry equipment that produces grade D breathing air. The only way to guarantee grade D is to test it, which you typically can't do on site. So how do we protect all these blasters and painters? All these amazing human beings who have families, friends, and decades of life ahead of them? Well, let's explore some simple procedures you should definitely incorporate into your job site setup that increase the chances of delivering grade D to your respirators. Let's take a look at the three pillars and quickly run through these. The general atmosphere is 20.8% oxygen. This falls perfectly within the specs needed for the oxygen component of grade D. So unless you are in an oxygen deficient area, you should definitely meet that criteria. Place your compressor in a well-ventilated area, ensuring its exhaust or exhaust from nearby trucks or site equipment doesn't get drawn back into the unit and compressed into the supplied air system. Now, this holds true for low-pressure ambient systems as well, as they may draw an exhaust from vehicles or other site equipment. If need be, install a remote air intake to keep it away from contaminated air. Ensure your compressor is the correct size and is well maintained to prevent it from overheating and creating carbon monoxide. Now, when installing a breathing air system, we recommend the following items. Use a Radex filter, which has activated carbon to remove odors, and the Radex also has activated alumina that absorbs moisture. We also highly recommend a micro mist filter, which helps remove moisture and hydrocarbons. And with any breathing air system, it's absolutely required that you need to monitor the air for carbon monoxide. At BlastOne, we strongly endorse the RPB GX4 gas monitor, which from our experience definitely meets the criteria for being deemed superior equipment. And last but not least, regular testing of your air is critical. Grade D air test kits are available from BlastOne, which you can send in to get certified. Now, how often should you test? Well, if you have a fixed work site with pretty much no changes being made to your setup, OSHA recommends a minimum of once a year. Otherwise, under its own guidelines, you should be certifying your air every time you move your equipment. Reality says you're not going to be able to do that, which makes it even more important that you employ the previously outlined procedures to keep your workers safe. Thanks for watching this week's Primed Insight. We'll see you next week.